You noticed that you took the photograph first because you start looking.
No, my God, you're not allowed.
I'm not allowed, okay. Because by the end, my face is going to be all red, mascara is going to run down my face, so we went to get a fresh photograph first. It was really hard to find a date for these girls to play this concert today, and even harder to get them to come over to my basement to practice. That was really difficult. But we did. They're very busy girls. Boy. I do wish that this last concert was out by our pool where we were having the delicious beverages and food and the kids were swimming. But as always, and so I was saying, we can find wine at the church. But thank you so much to the Martz family who always come through for us. Thank you. And Father Sam. In the office, but thank you. We really appreciate having this as our Phortissimos home. We are going to be passing around an offering basket during one of the last songs, so give generously. Although Gabrielle thought maybe that money should go to the seniors. And if it doesn't, she's willing to share her Venmo ID. So just ask her. Yes. We are going to try, keyword try, not to be sad.
Here I go already.
This is a celebration of our five senior girls. Don't look at me like that at all. Emma, Kristen, Gabrielle, Kendall, Nadya. Oh, we've had a good time with them, that's for sure. And I hope that you all saw the shrine. Did you see the shrine over here? If you don't know what I'm talking about, there's some photographs over here of all the girls from when they first started to just recently. And that is a fun trip down memory lane. I counted that we have done 18 concerts as the Phortissimos. Can you believe it? So this will be our 19th. I wish it was our 20th, but maybe I'll come back next year for the reunion tour. Today, the theme is the best of the Phortissimos. So these are all songs, favorite songs that we played from past concerts. And I do want to say their name is still relevant because they still play too loud. And if anyone knows the musical term Phortissimo, it means to play loudly. And they do.
We're very good at it.
But I hope that you all remember how much fun we had together and that you have good memories as you grow older of us all playing together. Okay? Okay, so here are the Phoenixville Phortissimos in their 19th concert.
Good afternoon. Our opening piece is one of the classics of ragtime. The Entertainer by Scott Joplin was written in 1902, originally for the piano. It is a popular tune to all of us and was used as the theme music for the 1973 Oscar-winning film, The Sting. Hopefully, our performance of this exuberant piece will entertain you.
Thank you.
Nadya, and it is written by Carl Jenkins. This piece was inspired by the Italian architect Andrea Palladio. It mixes mathematical harmony with classical antiquity. This piece was adopted by Jenkins for the Diamonds Is Forever commercial that it is most well known for. The Phortissimos last played this piece in 2018 during our summer concert.
This is our last concert. I'm trying not to get emotional, but I just want to say thank you for just everything that you've done for all of us. Your encouragement. Don't cry, please.
Thank you. violins by Peter Martin. Writer and composer Peter Martin was born in West Yorkshire in 1956, where he devoted his life to studying and playing both the violin and the viola. Martin wrote and arranged countless pieces in his lifetime, and we hope you enjoy our rendition of this piece for you this afternoon. If your third and final parts are familiar, you may have heard a version of it while you played Chase's favorite video game.
Old
favorite video game, Super Mario Galaxy.
Thank you.
by Gabrielle Farray. Gabrielle Farray was born in Pommadier, France, 72.8 miles from the border of Andorra in 1845. He studied under the well-known composer Saint-Saëns at the Paris Conservatory. Later, Farray became the school's director for 15 years. Farray is known for his refined, intimate quality. The Bon was composed in 1887 for a series of light music before a summer concert. The Pavane is a dance usually in 2-2 or 4-4 meter performed in 16th and 17th century Europe. Until halfway through the 17th century, the Pavane was usually performed in church services or open ceremonial halls. Farray's Pavane is one of the most popular pieces played globally.
Thank you.
Okay, so now it's time to talk about and honor our senior girls. I can't see. Is that Gabrielle?
Yeah, I can't see you.
I apologize in advance if I choked up because I practiced this 4 times. And 2 of those 4 times I was sobbing. So I apologize. I might have to have Mesa come up and take over for me. excuse me. So for years, the girls have been making me misty-eyed. You know, when you play a beautiful song, you're like, oh, you made me misty-eyed. Well, one year, Gabrielle said, Miss Alice, you should get a teardrop tattoo on your cheek. Well, I don't think so, Gabrielle. But instead, I got you teardrop-shaped gifts. And I looked long and hard for something. It's really hard to find. And if you don't like it, blame your moms because they had a hand in choosing each one for you. And if you don't like it, I do have other options up here. You can come see them. Okay? But and if you don't like it, just like hang it in your room in school or something.
Yeah. Think of me once in a while. Okay.
Oh yes, and when I talk about you, please remember that I could go on and on and on with the rest of the Phortissimos and your family want to get home. So I'm just touching on some of the highlights, okay? There's a lot more to you than what I have written down, so please remember that. Okay. We're going to start with Emma, because she was the first one back in 2014. Mr. Clapper recognized the talent in 3 of these young 3rd graders, and it was Emma, Kristen, and Gabrielle. And Emma was the first one, or Emma's mom was the first one to email me and get in touch, and she came first for lessons. And Emma loves music, loves to play the violin, plays percussion, has a gorgeous, beautiful, crystal clear voice. You've played in the, what's it called, the percussion ensemble, what's it called? The what?
Front ensemble.
For 4 years now?
Two years.
Oh, wow. She's played in the Reading Junior Orchestra and the Reading Youth Orchestra. She's an extremely talented photographer. She loves history. She volunteers. There's a theme with this volunteering thing, so listen for that. She used to work at Molly Maguire's and had lots of fun stories about that. She comes from her lessons on Mondays, and she has some interesting stories that happened over the weekend. But most recently, she worked for her aunt at a publishing house for history curriculum. And last summer, they went to England to do research, which was like just a fun trip to reward themselves, actually. But you learned a few things, I'm sure. On Easter Sunday, Bayside, little June and I had a flat tire. We were at Charlestown Park, and I was calling people. No one answered. It was Easter Sunday. They were busy. And the first, I thought, which one of my students who drives would say yes? Emma was the first one. I called her. She immediately picked up, and she came to the rescue. So we thank you for that.
I'm a taxi driver.
Yeah. And she had classical music playing on in the car when we got in. She's going to Susquehanna for history in Spanish, and she gives the best hugs. You come up here, Emma, give me one of those hugs. Diplomat and the peacekeeper in the group. rarely says anything negative about anyone or takes sides. She is just always positive, and I love that about her. And she plays her violin beautifully. And we have a lot in common because we enjoy playing the harmony part, and we have no desire to play those high squeaky notes, no desire to sit the violin one section. And we just enjoy playing music with others, just have fun with others, right? Kristen also volunteers and has had many jobs, like I said, but one I know she loves is babysitting. And that means she has chosen the perfect major, elementary education. Kristen, Kristen will be attending the University of Pittsburgh 4 hours away. It's just 4 hours. You can do it. Why so far, Kristen? But congratulations, Kristen. Gabrielle is the comedian of the group, no surprise there. She is so quick-witted and has often diffused stressful situations in the group. Are you sensing a thing that this past year we had a lot of stressful situations? They were so stressed out from their AP exams, their college applications, getting accepted, lots of stress, right? But it's all over now, I think. It's all over, a few more AP exams to take, yeah.
One more week.
But yes, Gabrielle has certainly made things lighter with her humor. Hey, she wore a flamingo poof on her head for a concert. And if you haven't seen that picture over there, make sure to see that. She also played in the Reading Junior Orchestra, the Reading Youth Orchestra, and the Delaware County Young Musicians Orchestra. Gabrielle is very athletic. She runs track and has played soccer through most of her childhood for clubs and all through middle and high school. Yes. Did I miss anything?
No.
No. Okay. She works at Sedona Tap House now. And she used to work at Rita's, which was a very sticky job, wasn't it? And she also volunteers. She is attending American University in Washington, D.C. for journalism and political science. And we've had some really fun political discussions after lessons, haven't we?
Yes.
Okay, congratulations, Gabrielle. Kendall. Kendall came to me when you were in the seventh grade. She was already playing bass and the trumpet and the violin at the school, and she came for violin lessons and then decided to also add piano lessons. And she also plays in the, what did we call it? The front ensemble, that means percussion, right? Instead of marching, you stand there and keep the beat, right? You play in that, and every instrument under the sun, and last summer you bought cello. How's that going? In 10th grade, though, she discovered her passion for the viola. Was it 10th grade or 11th? 10th? Yeah. And it's become her instrument. She's played in district and regional orchestras, and this past year filled in with my string quartet on Christmas Eve and played in the viola section of the Mainline Symphony with me, which was a lot of fun for me. She's very organized. Every minute of the day is filled. She works long hours, also volunteers, does the band, makes it to her lessons, even if it's just for 15 minutes, you show up. And, okay, I might have to leave this out. Okay, I'm going to get through this. She even showed up on the day that her beloved Pop passed away. We were both in shock, and we did what gives us comfort, we play music. And Pop was our biggest fan, Kendall's biggest fan, and we really miss him a lot. But now her mom and Kendall are taking over his tradition and doing the videos, right? Where are they? There's Madonna with the video camera. Kendall is attending West Virginia University. What? Oh, not anymore?
Purdue.
physics, okay. And you will be continuing in ROTC. And then after 4 years of Purdue, joining the Air Force, correct? Yes. And I was going to say that she'll only be an hour away from Kristen in West Virginia, but where's Purdue?
12 hours.
12, Kendall.
Well, congratulations, Kendall. So, Nadya. I don't know a whole lot about Nadya because I don't see her every week in her lesson, but I do know that she is a sweet and very lovely lady. And she's only had a year or two of lessons with Pam, right? About a year or two? Yes. So everything that you hear is basically what she has taught herself, correct? What you've worked on or taught herself, yes. So which I think that is amazing. When Nadya can't attend the group practices, I kind of know that it's not going to go as well as I'd like to because she is our rock, keeps a steady tempo and a beat. I don't conduct, so I rely on Nadya to come and conduct with her cello. So it's been wonderful. At Christmas time, she came and brought me a plant, which I still have. I have not killed it. And we had such a nice chat. I'm so glad you did that. Thank you. I've been to hear her sing in her vocal fusion group at Chaplin's, and I was very impressed by the group and her singing, her solo singing. I'm so glad I went. Ursinus, you're going to Ursinus for business. And I was going to tell your mom that she won the prize because you're staying the closest to home. You can pass that on to her. And I'm sure she's very happy about that. Yes. Okay. Congratulations. I wanted to pull that theme together of everyone volunteering because, was it in your junior year, Emma, National Honor Society, you had me be your person of influence.
Yeah.
Okay, that was a real honor. So I went to the ceremony and I saw all five of these girls were there. They had all been accepted into the National Honor Society. And the qualifications for that, they must be leaders. They must do service work, they must have a high GPA, and they must have good character. So all five of these girls were there, and that's just giving me goosebumps. Now the seniors are going to play a piece together by their favorite artist, well, three of them, it's their favorite artist. The great, wonderful Harry Styles. And the lyrics to the chorus are, in this world, it's just us. You know, it's not the same as it was. In this world, it's just us. So, it's a bit of a stretch, but we're going to say that in our little Phortissimos world, it's just us. And you all are going out into the world and will discover so much more and hopefully keep up your playing and meet other like-minded musicians, and remember all the fun times you had playing with the Phortissimos. I love you all.
Thank you.
16th concert together, they have chosen to play The Arrival of the Queen of Sheba from Act 3 of Handel's oratorio, Solomon. And this is the Phortissimos signature song. Christmas, it's sleigh ride, but this is the big one, The Queen of Sheba. They wanted to play the OG version. We tried different versions, but they love this one. And it's brought us many good memories over the past 9 years. We played this at our very first Phortissimos concert in 2014 at a really, really slow tempo. So, ladies and gentlemen, the fabulous Phoenixville Phortissimos playing their signature song, The Arrival of the Queen of Sheba. And if you hear the piano stop playing, that's because I can't see through my tears. So keep it going. The cello section.
Thank you. it's been a while, and you have played an incredibly huge part in our life. None of us would be where we are. We wouldn't have had half the accomplishments without you and your influence, so we want to thank you very much.
Yeah, I don't want to know. I just leave, walk out.